really targeting the emissions from natural gas appliances is one of the low-hanging fruits that we have to reducing these emissions of methane gas. In the United States, there are over 40 million natural gas stoves. Natural gas is composed of mostly methane, which is a potent greenhouse gas. In this research, we were trying to answer the question, how much methane do natural gas stoves emit, either while they're off, or while they're on, or while they're turning on and off? We found that methane emissions from natural gas stoves are equivalent to about the carbon dioxide emissions from 500,000 cars over a 20-year lifespan.
We found a couple of interesting things. The first was that most of the natural gas we found leaking into the air from stoves wasn't while the stove was in operation, but just simply leaking while it was off from fittings and leaky pipes and things like that. So that was the first surprise. And the second was that the amount of methane leaking out of stoves was higher than we expected and higher than estimated by the Environmental Protection Agency.
Simultaneously, we were also measuring the amount of nitrogen oxides, NOx, that were emitted during combustion of the stove. Given the rates of NOx emissions from stoves, we found that the exposure threshold of 100 parts per billion can quickly be exceeded in the matter of minutes just by using your burners and ovens. The mere existence of these gas stoves are really driving the emissions. So it's not how much they're used, but it's the number of them and the leakiness of the stove while it's off.
Methane leakage from stoves could be eliminated, but we can't eliminate the carbon dioxide emissions from burning natural gas. So at some point, and at some point quickly, we need to replace all of our natural gas appliances for cleaner electric appliances. And there are a lot of good reasons for doing that. Climate change is one, but human health and air quality is another.